Hello, let's just check this out. Sorry. Hi again, and welcome to Minecraft. Just a little bit faster. Well, it's Minecraft, and it's just a little bit faster. So this is part two. So I hope you hope the first part was all right. I don't mind the squeaky voice. It's fine to laugh at the squeaky voice. No, it's totally okay. But you must also listen to the squeaky voice, you know, my squeaky voice, because I speed it up. Because I know what I'm saying, and there's, you know, it's important information, so you should listen to the squeaky voice. So anyway, thank you, and I hope you enjoy it. That's it.
Hello, welcome back. This is Black Sheep, and I'm doing my rite of passage for Minecraft for my YouTube channel, which I have decided that Minecraft is the rite of passage. So I must go through it and do a let's play of Minecraft before I can actually move on to anything else. Okay, so if you've joined me from the previous one, ooh, there's a zombie. If you joined me from the previous one, I've built this. It's not much, but it is something. Wow, Misha really looks these. This is, oh yeah. Okay, I'm not gonna keep saying like what pack this is. This is Misha's realistic resource. Misha's realistic 64x64 resource pack, and yeah. Oh look, this one doesn't have a head, so it's really yeah. And you can go. I talk about it more in previous things on the previous ones. So anyway, all right. This rotten flesh is pretty useless. Oh, come on, really? Oh yeah, I'm playing on hard, so I guess this is why. So. We can, we've, I've survived so far, you know, I've survived so far, and I've got like a couple of stuff here. And see, you can see me regenerating my health now because my food is full. What the heck? Look at this guy. Oh no, this is the skeletons. Wow, Misha did a good job, I'm not gonna lie. That looks really cool. Okay. So then you can take some damage, and then, yeah, you still regenerate, okay. Oh yeah, those balls, if you're wondering what they are, these are XP balls. Yes, I know it sounds weird, but yes, they are actually, and then they increase your experience here on the, you can see there's this green bar. I haven't talked about green bar before, so I'll talk about it now. It's experience. And you build up experience by mining blocks and by killing enemies, mostly just killing enemies because then you get the must. But what's weird about it is that it's used for enchanting, as far as I know. It's used for enchanting, and enchanting is actually sort of a pain because it's actually quite far up the crafting tech tree. You need like obsidian for a crafting table, I think. And I mean, for obsidian, in order to mine it, you need like a diamond pickaxe, so you need at least like 3 diamond, which. Yeah, which will take you a while. I mean, you won't get that first, you know? So it'll take a while, and I mean, you'll store. Oh, and you lose all XP if you die as well, that's all. Oh, golden leggings. How cool is that? I didn't know they dropped that. There's an arrow, there's some bone, and I have some seeds, and got some saplings and oak saplings. Okay. I just encourage you if you wanna if you have this, right, just plant it. It's as simple as that, just drop it, doesn't matter where. Just so that in the immediate vicinity, like here, you have a couple of trees. Like just here. Just to make sure you don't like destroy all the trees. So you just make a couple of trees, just to make sure that because it is possible to deforest your area and then you'll have a little bit of an issue. Okay, you can also see there's armor now. I've got armor, depending on what, you know, what I wear, etc., etc. Okay, let me just take a. So I'm drinking coffee. Oh yeah, that's good. Keeps my throat nice and clear. I'd also suggest you go grab a beverage. Alright, so let's look here. What should be my next task? The next task should be probably to get a chest, because see my inventory is getting pretty full. This rotten flesh, it serves a purpose, but you can feed it to like wolves if you train them, and you can train them and make them tame. But yeah, I don't know. I haven't successfully used it yet, so for me it's actually useless. Now if I let me just see, is Q the drop button? Yes, Q is the drop button. If you want to drop something, you equip in your hand, you just press Q, and then it throws it out. Okay, but that's rubbish. I don't want that. So now let me get a chest first. Let me make a chest. A chest I can't remember, so I'll have to experiment. I think it's like that. Okay, let me just get all that out. Here I only have one wood left. Okay, I think it's like that. No, that's a trapdoor. Or it's just a full box. Yes, with one empty, so that's a chest. Okay, so we'll make that. And then you can just put in here whatever you want to put in here. Okay, so you can put your bones in here. You can put in seeds in here, arrows. You can just put some stuff in here just to make sure, you know, just to clear up some inventory space. That's basically what's there, but I can see I don't have that much. And I have some other raw uncooked, so let's use my charcoal to. Let's use like two for that, and then we'll see how many is cooked, or three. I think it should be enough to cook all of it. Alright, you can leave that, I mean, it'll cook, and you don't have to touch it or observe, but it's kind of cool if you want to check. The next thing is I want to mine deep, fortify a little bit, and then mine. Okay, so let's open here. If you don't, if you want to destroy leaves, don't use a tool. If you use a tool, then the tool will break, like a pick or a shovel or whatever. Then so I'll need some wood because I want to craft ladders now. I want to show you a mining technique that I have. That I found to be effective. Because ideally, you want to go down, you want to mine some stuff, and you want to get some resources. I usually leave one, like I said, so that the leaves in the previous video, so that the leaves don't dissipate, so that they stay there. So in case you want to build a sky highway, that's useful for there. So you just dig like that. Right. One, two, and then maybe leave like the top. Okay, I see the creeper. I see him. Okay, to kill a creeper, you maximize your range. Maximize your range. See, and then you get the gunpowder. But I'm not too afraid of dying because I've just saved there with my bed, so it's okay. Even if I die here, I can quickly come back and collect the resource. So it's not that big of a deal. Okay, there. I've got 22 now. I'm gonna need quite a few. So let's just do that. Oops, yeah, there. See, there I cut out all the wood blocks. Okay, there. 26. I suggest you play Minecraft with some music of your own, because the background music only like occasionally plays. Do not overdo it, or I'm not exactly sure why that design choice, but whoops, there, I also did it now. See, the leaves are disappearing. Okay, so that's not, I mean, it's not too bad. I mean, you can always rebuild them. You can always rebuild the build in the air, so it's not that bad, but it's a semi-good idea. But if you want to deforest properly, you have to cut down all the, every single wood block. So then the leaves will disappear from the tree, the leaf blocks. Ah, man, I'm getting excited now. At least I haven't played this game in ages. There we go, alright. I'm getting psyched. That's good, that's a good thing. Because like I said, this game can take a while, and probably the biggest problem with it, especially if you're playing like single player and there's no real goal except, you know, whatever goal you make for yourself, you can tire of it. You can tire of it. But, I mean, I'm just here to... I'm pretending that you haven't played this game before. I'm gonna pretend that you haven't played this game before, so... Because it's like an official let's play. See, so, I cleared this area. And, what I'm gonna do, okay, I've got a lot of... As you can see, I've got a lot of, oak now, or wood. How's this? Yeah, see, that was enough for all of that. And then we'll cook that some more. And then we'll put it in our chest. And we'll keep two on our persons, and then we'll go to the here, or I can just put it in here, and then shift, click, hold shift and click, and then you can see it made like all of the lovely planks. And I'll put in some planks, or should I just take, let me, I'm thinking now, I think I should put in some, at least like 20 planks here, just for reserves. Okay, so what I want to do now is I want to build ladders. How do you build ladders? Well, you put that, and that, you put like, and then you shift, click, and then you get sticks. It's okay, I got a lot of sticks now. So let's just do that again, and then we'll get some more sticks. Okay, shift click again. And then you build like a ladder, like this. Okay, so if you want to build the ladder a little bit faster, you like drop in a couple in each block, like that. So it's right click, left click. Right click here, split it in half, left click. So see, that's more or less everywhere. If you want to make it a little bit more, you left click here, you make all nines. That's there, 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 there. No, oops, one too many, but that's okay. Then you shift click here, and you get three for each one, so that's 3 times 9. It's 27. Okay, that's not too many, but we'll continue this process. We'll continue this process. So that. Shift click. So you want about 64. And then we'll put those there. Put those there. Shift click. Shift click. Wow, the weather is kind of loud. It's good effects though, eh? Shift click. Okay, there we go. We got about 64 now, we still have plenty of planks left. Yes, and you want to deposit things. Oh, I've even got more birch wood, so keep that as well, and I'm putting that there. I've got a sapling, I'll plant that. Put in some coal here, just for reserves. Wool also, dirt. Yeah, we'll keep some dirt. Keep some dirt with you always, in case you need to build like a quick path or something. Dirt is great, because it's not affected by gravity like sand is. Wool and gravel. Alright, so now I've opened the area up a little bit. I'm gonna plant another tree here. And these have dropped, so I'll collect those. Just to make sure that, like I said, you have some wood in the area around you. Otherwise you have to keep going further out for getting wood. And you do use up your wood depending on what you wanna build. Oh, these are dangerous areas. Okay. I will ignore those. Okay, my area now is a little bit exposed. I should try and use a dirt block to make a little bit more of a fortification. Especially if I'm gonna go mining now. Whoop! Something is attacking me. Oh, the witch! The witch is attacking me. Oh, attack back, attack back. Attack, whoo! Yeesh, this is like my second time encountering witches. Ow! Ooh, I even got a glass bottle that I don't know what to do with. And glowstone dots that I also don't really know what to do with. Spiders and stuff. I think those are bring ingredients, including the glass bottle. But alright, as you can see, that was quite dangerous, so we need to increase our fortifications. So how do we do that? Well, I used up all my stone, so I can't build more shovels. But I'll just continue to use the shovels. I'll dig out this area here, so... Yeah, I'll dig out exactly this area right here. This area where I've dug a little bit already. Dig like that. Okay. I mean, you're free to do whatever you want. I mean, that's one of the coolest things about this game is, you know, you can go wherever you want. You can dig, you can mine, you can... Okay, see there, it's broken now. I'll just use our backup. See, I'm glad I have that backup now, right? So, hit that. And then I'll just keep digging deeper. Just like that. There we go. Oops. A little bit too much. No, that's okay. This doesn't look so neat. Let's dig this also out. There we go. Oh, is it a zombie creeper or is it a creeper? No, it's a zombie. Okay. Oh. I heard him, but I thought he was far away. All right. Oof. I must be careful now, I don't want to die. Okay, so double tap forward, and you can sprint. Escape to a higher location. That's why I said, like, building up high is a good idea. Let's use my apples. Because if your food bar is too low, then you don't regen health. But see, now I'm gonna go back to regen. Okay, good. Let's use the dirt box I've collected to build. Here. Let's build here. Whoop, oh dear. Oh! That was close. That was close. Alright, we'll just collect all these. All the dirt blocks, and then... Oh! Ah! Ouch! Okay, and then just collect these dirt blocks. Oh dear. Yeesh, man. Can't remember if I played it last time on hard, or if hard was even available when I played it. Eat my another apple. Okay, I'll just destroy this block as well, because it's strange what's up there. Like that. Da-da-da-da. Oops. Okay, there we go. Yep, oh, that's too hot. There we go. Let's repair this over here. Okay, so that's not working. Back to the height it was. And, oops. Back. 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. Mm-hmm. A faster way of doing it is like this. Which you just hold it in and then you reverse. And then you just take out those ones. Oh yeah, I left there. Okay, I see it won't deforest because of that one. These leaves won't fall because of that tree. That's blocked, it's still there. Okay, well, it looks a little bit, you know, a little bit better. Not ideal, but okay. I think I should deforest some more. I think there's too many trees here. There we go. Whoa, you can dig far, eh? Okay. Now I shall wait for that to drop and fall so that this is deforested, and then I'll continue down here. Because if you want to build fast, you get your block and then you reverse. You hold it in and then you reverse. Like that. You make a few mistakes, but that's alright because, you know, you gain because you go faster. And okay, we'll dig out here. Alright, there's a... How do I want this to look? Let's see here. Yeah, I think I'll continue here. There and there. Yes, I think that's all right, and I can continue building up there. Yeah. Yes, it's coming together now. It's coming together. That's probably one of the biggest things, the coolest things about this game, is when you decide on a project or something, and then it comes together. You know, when it gets built. When your project comes together and it's not just like a mess. We'll clean up this hole, fill that all up. See, and it's so quick, you just right click. Oh yeah, that's how you place blocks. You just right click. Okay, so this part is a little bit confusing, but we'll sort that out later. For now, I'll just build like a two block high wall around the area. Do. Okay, I'm gonna destroy that. Do I have some more? No. I'm out of dirt. Whoopsie. You see, I overshot it now. So you can see it's like a wall around there. And then, you know, here is, it's just like, I overshot it a little bit, but that's okay, because it doesn't matter. I can just continue. Let's go get some more. There we go. Okay. Great. Let's continue. So this is like most of Minecraft. Most of Minecraft is like this. You're sort of doing your own thing. I mean, even on servers, you know, the people are like mining and crafting and like digging blocks, building blocks. So I mean, it's very sandbox. It is very sandbox. There's some elements like as you've seen of combat and so forth, but most of it is creative. So if you're gonna play this game, you're definitely gonna have to, you know, like stretch your creative muscles. You're gonna have to be imaginative. Now this is bothering me now. Let's get rid of that one. So then it'll fall now. La 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 la. Oops. Yeah, one too many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, I'm running out of building blocks. Is that all the dirt I have? Oh no, man. Come on. Aha, see? That looks nice. It looks better, you see? It looks better. And that's the deal. Like, you want to build on that. You want to build on how cool the place looks, and you want to improve it and so forth. I think now is a good time to go mine. Oh, we'll get some pork chops. You know, eat that. That restores like 4. I think these good stuff restores like 4. So I'll keep that. I'll just sort out some of my inventory. Definitely keep my ladders. I'm gonna need that. I'm gonna need all of that. And my... I'll suggest you keep like some planks and some sticks and some stones on you at all times. The reason for that is then you can craft basically anything. On the, you know, if you're stuck in a situation, you know, you can craft your way out. You can craft your way out, you can build your way out, you know, if something of your tool breaks, or you need a ladder, for example. Ladders are awesome. like I said, because when I played in beta, I didn't have ladders. And when they put in ladders, I don't know, I never really used it much, but then later on, there was a time where I really got, where I got the use of it. Okay, so, you're probably wondering what the hell I'm doing now. This is the mining pit. We're gonna do a mining pit right here. This is where I'm gonna go mine. I'm gonna go mine there, okay? Let's listen to my own advice. Here we go. Jump. There we go. It is much faster. I should always do it like that. This is the mining pit. So, what is the mining pit, you ask? Well, the mining pit is where you're gonna mine. I highly suggest that you save before, like, you must get your, you must go and sleep before you do this. Like, before you do this. And ideally, you want to box off this area and, like, put in a door and, yeah. Because this is what you want to do. Okay, I'm out of that now, but, you're basically gonna break the one rule of Minecraft. There's a couple of rules of Minecraft. There's only 2 rules, actually, of Minecraft. Never dig straight up and never dig straight down. Those are the rules of Minecraft. Never do that. So I'm gonna break that rule, because it's the fastest. Like, it's the fastest way to get, you know, proper mining. Oh dear. Okay. Yeah, I can't even. Okay, so I just realized that you can't place a ladder. Oh no, wait, you can. There we go. So you dig, place a ladder. Dig, place a ladder. Dig, place a ladder. And if you press shift. Okay, no, if you press shift, you can't dig through, but you can, okay, how a ladder works is you jump up, and then you have to continue pressing up. You'll fall down if you don't, but if you hold shift in, then you can stop. But I don't think you can dig here, so you can't mine while being on a ladder. So you'll have to sacrifice yourself, so you're doing this. So basically, you dig a couple of bits, and then you place a ladder. Dig a couple of bits, dig a ladder, put a ladder, no, you get the idea. You put all the useful stuff in up there so that you won't lose them. I'm not sure, maybe in hard mode they drop, I'm not entirely sure. If you want light, you just dig in here, right? And then you take a torch and you put it in here, just like at intervals. Because the biggest problem is if someone walks in and falls in here. So you actually want to close off this area, so I'm actually breaking that rule as well. So I'm being very stupid. There we go. 1 and 2, yeah, okay. You can also, the bottom grid is snapped to your button. I'm assuming you're playing on computer, on PC. So if these buttons are corresponding to your, to like 1, that is 1, that is 2, that is 3, that is 4. So if I press 1, that's 2, that's 3. So I'll do 1. And so then it's just faster, then you don't have to use your mouse wheel all the time. So if you do 1, dig, 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 dig. And in case you need your sword quickly, you press 4. See? Okay, now there I dug too deep here. That was a mistake. If you did that, then you just pick up your cobblestone, place, you continue. The reason for this is that you can rapidly descend like that. You can descend rapidly without dying. There's a reason for all of this, you know, even though this sounds crazy. Because the reason why you don't dig straight down is you could dig straight down into lava or into a hole, because you don't know what's beyond the next block. You don't know. So this is actually, this is very risky. You shouldn't actually do this. But I found it is the best way, even if you die. Like, even if you die, it's the best way to get, like, to a... It's the fastest way to descend instead of digging, like, what is this even? Oh, this is granite. Oh, cool, man. Like, that's also a new thing for me. I didn't get granite last time. And as far as I'm aware, granite is extremely hard. Like, in real life, granite is, like, extremely hard. Like, dense or whatever. So you do this, so even if you die, then you just descend and then collect your items. And like I said, keep the best items in your inventory. Don't put it here in the... Right click, left, 1... This, dig, 3, right click. I'm being a little bit cautious. Like, if you're really hardcore, then you don't mind, then you just dig straight out. Like, but I would suggest doing this, like, you place a couple of ladders, dig, place a couple of ladders, dig, place a couple of ladders, dig. It's deep, eh? Because, by the way, if this is your first time seeing Minecraft, look at this, man. Look how deep that is. So I realize why I'm doing this now. Oh, okay, yes, we're starting to get ore now. I'm running out of ladders. That's already 64 ladders. Okay, so we're getting some useful ore here. This is coal. It's relatively useful. I mean, it's not like super useful, but it's, yeah. Okay, so this is a vein. We found a vein, so we'll just dig this out. There we go. Looks like that. I would also recommend placing a torch in any dark areas, because the problem is, if, as far as I know, see there, a bit of the music plays now. Oh, look, my pickaxe is becoming smaller because I'm using it up. Do I have a backup? Yes, I do. See? That's where those backups come in. See? Oh, and ideally, if you're like a pro, then you put in your broken pickaxe there, and then you use your other pickaxe of the same type, right? So that when you mine it and it's also, like, damaged, then you craft them together. You put them in here, you put the damaged one here, you put the damaged one in there, and a slightly more repaired one will come out. That's how repairing worked before the anvil, and which is what I know. So... Okay, so dig through here. So nothing bad has happened. Usually by now I've fallen into like a cave or something. And you'll notice this is cobblestone and this is stone. In order to get the same texture, I think you have to put it in a furnace. So you cook this and then you get stone. You bake it. As far as I can remember. I play some more. 1, dig. We'll get to it eventually. We'll get there, don't worry. Oh yes, look at this. This, my friends, is what I actually wanted. That is steel. That is steel. That is steel ore or iron ore. That's what I wanted. It's, what do they call it? Yeah, it's iron ore. And then you place it in your furnace and then you get steel or iron bars. I can't remember. I think it's steel. Whoa! Did you see that? That's why you don't dig straight down. You don't dig straight down because stuff like that happens. Alright, so now fortunately, we've been fortunate enough so that did not happen to us. So this will be the platform right here. So we can climb out here, you'll land here, and we'll dig out here. We'll dig out. Create some space. The more space you have to maneuver, the better. Like, the better you can strategize and decide, like, where you want to enter. Dig through here, okay. And I think this is my last torch as well, yes. And then you dig like that, reverse, and then see. Alright, straight down. And there's water over there. So, we'll dig down here. What you can do in that is, I'm trying to dig a ladder, so, stairs, yeah, I mean stairs. So you dig... Whoa, no, that's one too many. You dig like this. Okay, and that looks dark and scary. Okay, so... Dig through here. Dig. And got like 5. Okay, so this is where we are now. I can see there's some more steel over there and some more iron ore. There we go. Okay, so there's a lava. There's some water over here. Let's craft some torches. Okay, I hear them, but they're not here. Place some torches here. Okay, so this is infinite water, how water works. So if you put a block over here, okay, nothing, there it is. Then the water will clear up. I'd recommend doing this because, and I think as far as I know, if I destroy this block, yeah, the water has been destroyed. Because the water comes from this place, and then if you place a block there, you cancel it, and then you just destroy it, and then it's gone. Now obviously, this could have been a good place to get, you know, to get, this is obsidian. But, it's not such a big deal. It's not such a big deal. I can get that later, when I get to the point of getting, you know, diamond. Alright, so here we're now in a cave system. So that's why you do this. That's why you build the mine, this mine ladder, or this mining pit. So we'll continue doing that. Because then it's the fastest way to get to a cave system. Because you want to get to a cave system and you want to go low. Like as deep as you can go. Yeah. There we go. So then it's straight down, you just go all the way, and then here, you're at the cave system. And here, your odds of finding ore, useful ore like that iron ore over there, the odds are increased. It's much higher. So let's take this. Okay, and I'm running out of some tools, so that's not a bad thing. Because let's say, for example, you're stuck here, right? You're saying, oh, okay, I don't want to return to the surface just yet. How can I? I'm pretty stuck. My tools are almost broken. What do I do now? Well, this is the reason why you always take some wood with you, or you always take wood with you. So now you can repair that. See, red, and then it gets a little bit of extra. So now you just build another crafting table. Simple as that. There we go. And where do you place it? Usually, you want to place it like in the area. Like up here, maybe would be a good spot. You dig out a little bit here. Okay, yeah, you dig out a little bit here, and then you place your crafting table there. Now here you can craft whatever you need because we've been digging stone. You have more than enough stone to make any tools that you want. So you right click on here, and then you realize, okay, I don't have any sticks, but don't worry, I've got wood planks, so I'll make some sticks now. There, I have 32 sticks now, and what do I need? I need sticks and stones to make another stone pickaxe because that one's almost broken. Let's make another stone pickaxe. 2, 3, 4. If you want to make more, then you just do it like that. And you can make tools exactly. Shift click and then you make two pickaxes. Stone pickaxe. So then you're fine. You want another stone sword before my stone breaks? A shovel. The shovel is also fine. Shovel is also great. Sorry, the sword is like that. Another stone sword. Great. And this sword is almost broken. You don't really need to. The repairing isn't so crucial for your stone objects because, I mean, you can make a lot of them quickly. But for your steel, yes, it's important. Doing this little trick will help a lot before you can, like, get an anvil. Because an anvil costs, like, a lot of steel to make. Or iron. Okay, see, so now you're pretty much set up. And if you're afraid, right, that you'll be attacked, then you can always also make a chest. So you can make a chest here and then put a chest right here to store some of the items in case you're afraid of losing them. And if you don't want to return all the way to the surface. Because I've gotten down straight and it's easy. Like, returning to the surface is just walking straight up. But if you've gotten here through an elaborate system of tunnels and digging and so forth, then you're gonna get frustrated because you don't want to walk all the way back. This is why I suggest digging a mining pit right next to where you spawn, like where your home is. You just dig straight down, you get into this area, so it's close. Even if you die, you can return quickly. So put that there. I'd also suggest you carry some torches and then you just light up the areas where you are. Okay, see, so there's a skeleton. They can shoot arrows. They're quite dangerous because they do knockback. So we'll just light up the area a little bit. To just see if there are hazards ahead. Tack. You just left click. Can I hold it in? No, you can't hold it in, you must left click. But you can right click and that's block. And then here. So you see, this is the end of this cave system, so it's not that big. But that's actually okay. That's not a bad thing. You don't want it to be too big. Because you can always dig even more down. I think I'll destroy it now. Yeah, see. This is redstone, but I cannot collect it with a stone pickaxe. If I dig it with a stone pickaxe, the redstone is destroyed, and the redstone block is destroyed, and I don't get any redstone. So I'm gonna need to craft a furnace first, and smelt. Here we go, and we'll just collect some more of this. Because coal is always useful for torches, and for smelting stuff, and for cooking food. So you want a decent amount of it. Not too much, because eventually, if you're playing for a while, you'll realize that you have too much of it. So, because you don't use that much of it, but you do use a medium amount of it, like a substantial amount of it. So, but just monitor it, and you'll be fine. Okay, So I'm gonna go up here again. Let's dig there, dig there, dig there, and dig there. Okay, cool. So we got that. Because this is very important. This stuff is this is quite important. Yeah. Okay. Okay, we'll dig some more, yeah. And just check, like, how much do I have? I have 30, okay, that's not too much. But if you get to the point of having, like, 200 or 300, then you can stop. Like, then you have enough gold. Okay, there we go. I'll just keep that for now. Here's some more of this. And there's some more of that. Okay, so another tip is if you're digging holes like this, right, if you're going down, you're mining some stuff, cover it up again, like this. So then you won't go fall into it and stuff. And also, like this, if you're coming to a cave system that you're constantly going to have to come and jump over and explore a lot, then you can even get to the point of building stairs even. Or you can just destroy these so that you can walk straight through. It's a small thing, but trust me, if you're at a cave system for a long time, it makes a difference. But we'll just do that for now. And now you can go back to the surface. You can go back to the surface and smelt your stuff in your furnace, or you can stay down here and just make a new furnace. I think andesite. No. No, you can only use cobblestone, right? I've never worked with andesite or dorite or granite before. I'm just used to the old furnace. So you make yourself a furnace. You put a just dig out here more because I'm gonna need some more space. So basically, you build up like a semi-workshop down here. But that's only if you want. If you're feeling vulnerable, then you can go. That's 34, and then we'll need some, like, I don't know, maybe 9. Rather put too little, because you don't want to waste your coal. Yeah. And what we could do is we can do a cool trick that I want to try that I'm not sure will even work, but we'll see. I want to craft a lava bucket, and go scoop up some lava and then put it in here, and then see. And see what happens. Okay, so a bucket you can craft. Because this is essentially a waste, but a bucket you can craft like this. There we go. A bucket, cool. So I got my bucket now, and then you right click on lava, and then you can scoop up some lava, and you have a lava bucket. And then you should be able to put the lava bucket in there, and then the lava should not be consumed, as you can use it as fuel. But I'm not entirely sure if that's gonna work out. Okay, so the first thing you want to craft once you get some steel is actually a iron pickaxe, which is like this. Ta-da! And then we can, as you are, that one's a little bit broken, we'll use our stone pickaxe, we'll upgrade, there we go, we'll fix that a little bit. That's something else. Sort out a little bit, let's see what's here, the ladder, we'll put that there, the arrows, we'll put that there. Put the cobblestone there, oh dear, okay. Okay, now you have a brand new fancy iron pickaxe. And an iron pickaxe, as you can imagine, digs faster than a stone pickaxe. Wow, okay, those coals are actually pretty impressive. They burn for quite a while. So let's see, and so now you can see, like, I have a lot of stuff, and I'm like, oh, I don't want it to be wasted. Well, don't worry, you've got oak. Or you've got wood. There you go, so that's why you bring wood with you. There we go. Because there aren't any trees underground, in case you haven't noticed. So we'll dig up a little bit here. Yeah, see, it digs faster. Ooh, what's that? I think this is lapis lazuli, or lapis lazuli. It's a dye. You use this to dye stuff blue. Ah, see, so here we get it, and then we can just put our iron in here, in case you're afraid of it getting, snatched or stolen or whatever, or, you know, you're afraid of dying. Okay, so let's see if this works. Yeah, see, it does work. Okay, yeah, I feel pretty professional now. Collect some more lava. So if you want to be really cool, then you build your furnace, like, over here, your furnace, right next to, like, lava. A lava area, so then you can just keep fueling your fire with lava. Let's see how long it burns. Oh, that is really cool. Because I remember there was a time when this did work, but it consumed the bucket. So it consumed the bucket, so that is actually a cool thing, actually. I'm so excited, I'm gonna make another bucket, just because that was so cool. I'm gonna make another 2 buckets. Okay, 1, 2, do buckets stack? Yes, they do stack. That's good news. Ah, you know what? Let's just go ahead and make a lot of buckets. Because that is awesome, I'm not gonna lie, that is really cool. Oh no! Oh yeah, this is what happens when you put crafting items here and don't drag it back into your inventory. You just press E, they drop, and then you pick it up again. So it's not actually as bad as I made it out to be. One. And shift left click, so I've got 5 buckets now. I'm gonna fill them all with lava. There we go. Do they stack? No, they do not stack. Okay, that is unfortunate. They should actually stack. Stone axe. Well, I can throw the stone axe in lava. I think it gets consumed. Yeah, I think it does burn. Like, if you want to get rid of some weird stuff that you have in your inventory and you don't want, or, you know, that's just in the way, like this wooden pickaxe, I'll just throw it in there. Okay. So I've got some lava buckets now to add fuel. Look at that! Look how much burning power it has. That's really cool. I'm gonna bring up some lava buckets to the surface. And then obviously the next thing you want to make with iron is you make like two iron pickaxes, right? You don't really need to make an iron sword. Iron sword isn't really that awesome. To be honest, you don't really get a lot out of it. Wow, look at that. There's still a lot left. Okay, so we'll put some buckets in here. Wow, that's really impressive. I'm actually very impressed. Yeah, I don't know where all the enemies are. The enemies are supposed to... Okay, if you want to craft... Okay, then you craft... sorry. You craft like two pickaxes. Just one for normal and one for backup. I'd say it's a good idea. And then you craft armor with the rest of it. Craft armor with the rest of it. Do like that is a iron boots. And... do I have enough? No, I need one more. That's a helmet. One more would have been a helmet. How do you equip it? You just press E and then you click there and then you wear it. And then you see my armor is going up. Alright, so I think I actually mined all the... Yeah, so now let's get some redstone. See, now the redstone has dropped. I'll pick it up. See. Okay, so I think I mined all the steel or the iron ore that's here. And we'll fill it up again. But I've not mined all the coal. Yeah, see, this is much faster. Now, once you get to a cave system, you can either dig in any direction. One of the good things to do. Just get some light here. You must just be always careful of when you go into a pit, right, like this, that enemies can drop in from above. So you want to just be wary of that. Just be wary of that. Okay, and then you fill it up, just so you don't fall in, and then you dig like out like that. So if you want to continue a cave system, you'll realize that here it sort of stops. And you can either continue, like there is something, you can see it's there. So you can either continue in the direction where it stops and then just dig in a direction. Or you can just dig straight down. Like, okay, here I think is some more. Let's see, do we need a light? Yes, this is some more steel here. More iron, sorry, iron. I'll get it right. Oh, this is sand, right? This is sand, yeah. Rather dig with your fist with the sand. Because, like I said, if you use a tool, it actually degrades when you're breaking a block. Whether it's supposed to be digging that particular block, you know, like using a shovel to destroy a wood block, which I believe is possible, but it's not very wise to do so. So you can keep digging here, you know, because this is actually the sort of like the unofficial end of that cave system. Oops, there, I'm not doing what I'm. So for sand, gravel, dirt, etc., etc., the tool to use is a shovel. Okay, but you see what I've done now? I've dug a hole here, so I don't want to fall into that hole. I want to cover that up, like that. There, see? And if this torch is in the way, just destroy it and just remake your path. Path building in this game is very important. You need to make sure you know where you are, where you're going. So building a path is important. Like here. You'll see that there's a nice path, but you can't really see out here, so then you'll dig out here like that, and you'll dig out here, because you want to be able to see, like, around the corner. You want to be able to see here. Like, maybe even dig out here. So that you can see, you know, that you get more of a visual idea. Or you dig out, like, all of this. Because this is here, this is in the way, you dig out all of this. So it's annoying, like it's work, but rather go slow, rather dig slow instead of running down here and exploring, getting stuff, and then you're getting lost. So rather go through it slow. I am going really slow now, but rather go slow through this and then be sure you have a path, you know, and build like the path as you continue. Because look at that, now the odds of you getting lost is not high, because the mistake at the beginning is you want to go deep into the. You want to go quick, and you want to explore, and you want to see what's over there, and you... Before you know it, you're lost. You're lost. Like, you've gone too deep. You can't find your way back. So if you... Look at this. You see? Now the path is open. Now it's very easy to not get lost. We'll destroy that water. Because that's a hazard, especially if enemies attack you, and that water pushes you away, or so forth. And the better you build your path, I mean, it's just better for you. If your sense of direction, even if your sense of direction is great, it's still a good idea to build a path, to be certain. For example, look at this. Here you can see, okay, there's some obsidian. But you can see that this could have been another system that could continue down there, and then you'll get lost. Like, you will get lost, trust me, man. I've I've gotten lost so badly, it's crazy. Even if you have a great sense of direction, the cave systems are so huge, it's so large that you will get lost. So being extra methodical, being extra careful, building a path, you know, looking at this, it just aids you. And besides, remember, you wanna Minecraft is about building as well. It's about mining and building. So if you collect, you know, in inverted commas, too much, you know, stone by digging out a path that's too nice or too obvious, it's okay, because you will use all the stone. It's not trust me, like you can quickly use up all the stone as building material. You saw when we built the dirt wall. So there, see, now I feel very comfortable here. I can see that there's some stuff down here. How do you approach the lava? Well, you just build into a block that's close to it. Like, for example, here you can see the lava. How can I cross this? Well, you press shift so that you don't walk over the edge, if you're in case, and then you aim with this at the edge, like that face there, and then you right click. So I placed this block on top of this block. You see what I'm saying? So then you can do that. See, and then you can actually explore nice and deep here. Okay, you build. See, there I've already used up a lot. Now I want to use up this gravel and decide. Now let me save that for decoration, because I think that you can decorate with that. Oh, look, we've been rewarded. Our efforts have been rewarded. This is the infamous diamond. I'm sure if you've just heard about Minecraft and you don't really know what it is, this is Minecraft, and this is the diamonds. I'm sure you've heard of the diamond stuff, and like the diamond armor and the diamond pickaxe and the diamond everything. So this is the rarest resource in the game, as far as I know. You know, when it comes to, you know, like crafting tech, I'm just gonna build out this a little bit more. Now this is obviously overdoing it, but it helps. So you build one there, you build one there, you build one there, build one there, you build one there. That's a little bit too much, but that's okay. You hold shift in, very important. Hold shift in. You place one on that edge. You place one on that edge. You place one on that edge, like that. See, come on, man. How cool is that? And then you can go through here. And if you get to lava level, then you've got a pretty good chance of getting diamonds. Like diamonds is at the level of lava, like where lava is. That's so. Diamonds, yay! See, I got diamonds now. So then here, that's very lucky. You don't diamonds are quite rare. And now if you look at, I got four, so that's excellent. That means that I'll use three to craft a pickaxe. That's the most important thing you can craft with diamonds, is a pickaxe. So even if you get your iron, also immediately grab a pickaxe. I'll make a pickaxe out of it. So we'll open up here. We'll make it methodical. We'll get some more here. I'll get rid of that water just now. There's some more fire over there. I'll dig out here. Alright, so because this water pushes you, as you can see, I'm trying to walk up here, but it pushes against me, and that is dangerous. That is why I usually, whenever I can, I will block it up. So you can see it's coming out of that wall, so I'm putting a block and then it stops. So then it's safe to walk again. Right. It's safe to walk here again. So, and this is obsidian, I can probably mine it now. Let's see. Yeah, okay, there's some more of that iron ore, that's important. I'll get that and then we'll block it off. Okay, I'm getting hungry, I think I'll return to the surface. Let's block up here in case I fall down here, because lava is extremely dangerous. The lava is very dangerous. If you touch it, you burn. It's very dangerous, man. So let's open up here, and we'll collect that. See, my steel pickaxe is almost. It's getting red now. So what you can do is you take that up, you swap it out with your backup. Oh, my backup! I left there at my backup. Okay. So no, not yet. But yeah. So you just dig out with it. Just don't break it. Just don't get to the point where you break it. Yeah. Get out like that. Get that. You get your backup. You can also jump and place blocks. Jump and place blocks is also a nice little trick. So alright, yes, here we can mine out a little bit more, and then you get the idea. Like you open up the place so that you make it obvious, like where to go next. You can see there. You will go much slower, but you'll obtain lots of stone, lots of cobblestone for mining purposes. Okay, I just want to make a comment. This is still burning. This was lava bucket. Yes, it's still burning. Wow, that is crazy. That is really crazy. Okay, let's put in another lava bucket. So then you don't use up your precious coal. So. Oh yeah, it must actually burn out first. Okay, so I'll definitely be doing my smelting down here with lava. I didn't think it was so useful, but now that I've learned something through this video. This is definitely the way to do it, is to put your smelting down here or wherever, so that you don't use your coal to burn up this smelting, to do the smelting job. You just use lava, because your buckets are reusable and it lasts so long. Wow, okay, I'm very impressed. So now let's make an iron helmet, make some leggings, is like that. I'm gonna need a lot more than that. Yay, cool. I look quite cool now. For leggings, you make legs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I need 7 of those. Do that. Yes, iron leggings. I already have gold leggings, but that was gotten from a skeleton, so... Oh, yeah, see. And then you just go fetch them all over. Like that. Okay, now this is a little bit awkward, so let's make this a little easier. And place some ladders here. Okay, we'll break that, because unfortunately that's in the way. We'll break that, and I'll put that torch over there, and this and there. Okay, and here we go. So there's all my lava bucket. I probably made too many, but I was really excited about how well it worked. I overdid it. Okay, so if you want to make chest armor, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pieces. We need 8 pieces. So that's 7, and we need one more piece. There, 8 pieces. And go to crafting table, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There we go, iron chest plate. There, now I'm Iron Man. See? Fully up equipped with iron. And we can, might as well collect the might as well collect this. Check ya, there. Ah, we might as well do that, yeah, pack it up in there. I'll recommend that you be very careful with your diamonds, like how you use it. And that you'll prefer, because as you can see, I'm still using my iron pickaxe instead of my diamond. No, that's because I don't want to waste it. Okay, see, so there I put the block through. I mined out there. Now I close it up. Pick it up. And then... Okay, yeah. So we're pretty set. This went really really well. I'll actually take some buckets up to the surface as well. I'll take some of those buckets to the surface. Let's see what I can leave down here. I can leave the sapling. No, the saplings I actually have to plant. The bones, the arrows. Dirt. Dirt I can leave here. Granite, gravel I can leave here. Or I can take it with me, because gravel, if you mine it with a... Whoops. If you mine gravel with a... sorry, let me just organize a little bit. Okay, if you mine gravel with a shovel, you have a chance of getting flint. That's how you get flint. So we're just... I'm not sure if you can sprint up a ladder. I don't think so. No, you can't. It's deep, eh? But that's how you get, like, that's how you get go down really quickly. So instead of, like, trying to dig stairs down, which is common. Oh, look. The grass has grown on the dirt. So here we go. Up, 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 up. Yep. And here's our other chest. I'm gonna put some stuff in here. Okay, so first of all, I'll have to increase the size of this chest. How do you do that? You build another chest. Oh, we've got some cooked stuff over here. That's very nice, because I can see I'm actually getting hungry now. Alright, so we'll eat the flesh, not the lapis lazuli. And now we make another chest. You're doing it like that, right? That's most how you do a chest, right? And then you take the chest and place it directly next to this one to make a mega chest. See? And now you go into it, and now you see it's nice and large. See? And we'll put our coal. Yeah, we'll put up our buckets on here. Try and categorize it, like, put it in a certain area. Like, for example, the wood is over there. Just to get a little bit of food is over here. That's if you don't want to make a chest for every single item. You know, that's obviously if you're going more professionally, then you want, you know, this can be categorized. Because this is like farming. This is wool, so that can just go there. Gunpowder, I don't really where to put that. That's probably with, like, weapons. And this is all. So then, dorite. So then. Can put this as a fuel box, then we can put. Keep like half of it there. Here we go. And flint goes there. Granite will go there. Gravel will go there. So just like it's semi sorted out. This, I don't know, redstone is also on its own. So go there. Go there, go there. And diamond we have there. I'll think about the diamond. You probably want to craft a pickaxe from the diamond, but I'll have to go do some research for what else I can do with a diamond, because I can't really remember. I mean, you can also craft your armor and your sword and stuff like that, but I'll leave that for next time, because we did a lot now, and I'm gonna stop there, and I'll continue later. Anyway, thanks for joining me. Hopefully we can continue next time. Cheers.